isn't that crazy that I'm not hiding from the public?
What? We're not gonna do this. We're not. 2-3 days ago, what were you doing? We're in quarantine. We're in quarantine. So kiss out the fat on that side.
Isn't it crazy that I'm not hiding?
Well, what were you doing for the past couple days? Sleeping? We're not gonna do this. Don't caca, monsieur. Not even 30 minutes after I posted my initial video about her nonsense, she went and posted an apology. So I was gonna make an Instagram video basically reacting to her apology, but you know what happens after? She goes and does a whole 30 minute plus live stream explaining, debunking everything that everyone is saying about her. So today we're going to first read the apology and then react to her debunking, okay? I'm so annoyed. because I honestly didn't think I was gonna have to do another YouTube video about this, but you guys have been blowing me up and I really, really wanna know what she's saying in this live. So that's why we are sitting at my desk. This is going to be a little bit different from all my other reactions because it's not gonna be like in the screen. We're gonna be watching it from my monitor on my MacBook, okay? So let's get into the apology that she posted on her Instagram and disabled the comments. But she disabled the comments for a lot of her shit from what I noticed. So let's just read it.
I want to address what's been happening on Twitter. I've used public chat rooms to socialize since I was a child. I shouldn't have been on some of those chat room sites, but I personally have never been involved in any racist conversation. I'm sorry to everyone that I offended. I'm a black woman. Half of my family is black from South Africa. As for the old song that's resurfaced, it was in no way tied to anything outside of my own personal experience. It was written in response to people who often use that term to hurt me. I made an attempt to flip its meaning, but recognized that it was a bad decision to use the term in my music. I understand my influence and impact, and I'm taking this all very seriously. I love you all, and I'm sorry for upsetting or hurting any of you. That's not my character. And I'm determined to show that to everybody moving forward. Thank you.
In my last video, did I not say she's gonna conjure up some PR marketed type of fucking response? That's all we ever get from these fucking celebrities and public figures when they do some bullshit, okay? They're never sorry. They're just forced to apologize, and their PR manager or their marketing team always conjured up some cookie cutter ass response to try to silence the masses. I'm very, very sure she did not write this. I'm very sure. An intern wrote this, an assistant wrote this. She did not write this shit, okay? I was fucking screaming, like, of laughter, because that shit was just so funny to me. It's like, how ingenuine can you be, you fucking idiot? Like, come on now, like, we're not stupid. Like, get it together. First of all, why did she have to throw?
Like, I'm a black woman, and I'm proud of where I come from.
You don't even really know where you come from, right? You never met your father, right? I find that really, really interesting because no matter how, like, whether you have hatred for your father that left you side of the family or race or ethnicity side of the family or not, you don't know them from what I understand. Like, I would assume you don't know them because you don't know your dad from what you said. She just threw that in there just to make it seem like, she's not racist or hasn't done anything racist or participated in any type of racist conversation. Like, in the clips that have resurfaced and a lot of other conversations, because it's not even just what was resurfaced, there were people actually commenting in my comment section as well, saying that they've been in this specific type of chat room where, you know, Doja Cat has actually been racist to them, which I don't know how true that is. Other things that surfaced as well, where, like, clearly you can see her laughing at racist jokes. Like, if that's not partaking in a racist conversation, I don't know what is. listen, this is an ass wipe apology. We all know it. I already know you guys are gonna ask because a lot of people were asking in my last video. My eyelashes are from Hortense Hibiscus. These are sponsored on my second channel, and I'm also giving two of them away. So you have to go subscribe to my channel and comment on that video to get a pair, okay? If you want to enter the giveaway, you can also just head down to Hortense Hibiscus and get a pair yourself. This video is not sponsored, just telling you guys where they're from. But the video that you will be clicking on my other channel is sponsored. This is my Pro Common Sense sweatshirt, got in a hoodie, got in a t-shirt. It's in my merch shop along with a whole lot of other designs. I love this, probably one of my favorite designs, because as y'all already know, if you already been here, I'm very pro common sense. I ain't pro nothing else. Makes sense for the moment is what I'm going with, okay? And yeah, this bitch ain't got no common sense. So let's get into this nonsensical apology. A different type of setup. I don't usually do this, but this is a lot easier when it comes to editing, so it is what it is, okay?
Here, isn't that crazy? Isn't that crazy that I'm not hiding from the public?
What? We're not gonna do this. We're not. What are you talking about? When did this shit first resurface? Like 2-3 days ago? What were you doing? We're in quarantine. We're in quarantine. So, kiss out the fat on that side.
Isn't it crazy that I'm not hiding?
Well, what were you doing for the past couple days? Sleeping? We're not gonna do this. We're not. God, I miss you. This has to be a joke. Like, I must be in some sort of fairy tale, because what is she talking about?
Another dumb thing is that I'm telling people to record me. I wanted to get on live and explain to everybody what's going on right now. I put out an apology last night. Mm-hmm. That was
horrible.
I kind of want to wait for everybody to get in here. Oh my God. 124 people. That thousand. So I wanted to get on here and tell you guys what's going on. The apology that I posted is absolutely an edited piece from me and the people I work with.
Wait. Got on fucking cozy. Is that not what I just said? Come on now. When you apologize for something sincerely, it should not be like edited or parts and pieces from other people. It's supposed to be sincerely from you and you only, because you did that action. And if you are sorry, you should be able to literally just say you're sorry if that's it. All of that shit that she said in that apology, as well as all of these other apologies that these celebrities and public figures always put out, is like absolutely nonsensical. All you have to do is, hey, I seen that this is floating around. I was wrong. This wasn't right. And you know, I'll literally never do it again. That's all you have to say. Do you need someone to edit an apology for? What, for what?
Like any conglomerate, there would be many people trying to protect what's going on. And that's exactly what we were trying to do. So I'm just gonna, one, debunk everything. I have bullet points here.
Debunk.
I just want to make sure that everybody's recording what's going on here. Not everybody. I guess that would be a little bit redundant to do that.
Debunk.
I need a charger for my laptop. I guess I...
So you're not going to give a legitimate apology on live? We're here to... You know what? Let's get educated. Maybe she will debunk, okay? She will debunk and relieve herself from all charges held against her in Jesus' name! It's like, now let me stop.
Rushed into this. Hold on one sec. Okay. I feel like it's been like 30 fucking years since I've been on live, because I love being on here so much.
Mm-hmm. But you were right on the public.
The mistake that we made was to not go on live, to not go on social media, to ignore social media. Sometimes it's good. Sometimes it helps. Sometimes it lets things deflate. But I've had 3 days to do this,
I understand. One thing of when I get hi guys. What's up, guy?
To be more detailed about what's going on, these are all apologies that I've compiled.
Hi.
Boo-hoo, woe is me. Mm-hmm. But this is what's been going on for the last 3 days.
Hey, guys. It's because I am movies. Hey, guys. I want to end this.
I'm not impressed.
I want to end.
Can we get to the point?
I want to end this.
Why are you wasting my time?
I want to end this video.
Check this out. There's nothing more ingenuine than making a fucking edited video.
I've been going in a chat room.
Put it down.
And asking other people, by the way, I've counted 98 different apologies. There is no better apology than me doing what I've always done, being on live, telling you guys my fucking truth, and being completely honest.
Okay.
It's a hard time right now, but recording myself apologizing and recording myself sounding perfectly diplomatic is the biggest fucking lie I can make to you. So I'm just gonna sit here and tell you what's going on in real time.
Yes, please, cause...
So, where are my bullet points? There's a lot of these videos. I was gonna go through all of them, but I feel like everybody would just be sick of that. So, I'm gonna start with self-hate.
Yes, please.
I've seen tweets about me. It's a video. It's not even me. It's my friends helping me see through Twitter with a filter. I'm not on Twitter. That shit hurts my feelings. People come for me, seeing people come for my character, just like any of you guys, it wouldn't feel good to me. So I avoid social media.
Okay. I like that she's very, very honest about that. That I give her that. And that's common sense. Like, if you see people dragging on Twitter, it's going to hurt your feelings. Even though it comes with the territory and you should definitely have thicker skin as a public figure, it does still hurt to an extent, especially when it's people that really genuinely used to support you and now they're, like, literally dragging you for filth. So I completely understand that. But the problem I have with this is the fact that, and this is with everyone across the board, if someone talks shit about you, whether it's in a video, a tweet, and you physically don't see it and you let other people tell you, like through a filter, you never get the full scope of what exactly is going on. Like, I've had so many people hit me up about other shit, like shit that like maybe Troyce has done or Tylan has done, whatever, and they're like, but I ain't watched the video though. And then like, how the fuck you coming to me to complain about one of my friends when you didn't even see what the fuck they said? Like, it just doesn't make sense. Like, you can't respond to shit that you did not see. I would hope that she actually has now went on Twitter to see what people are concerned about. I would hope that she's actually watched videos at this point and see what people are coming from, because this is not going to help the situation if you haven't watched anything that anyone's saying. Like, there's no logic in this whatsoever, and that just automatically annoyed me.
My friends looked on social media and they told me what was going on. I know exactly what you guys are talking about as far as self-hate goes. I had a video of me talking about my hair. I have a lot of trouble taking care of my hair.
A lot of people do.
So
especially
when I
horsey hair.
Am not either my hair is straightened or I have a wig on. I'm pretty much okay, but when I'm trying to comb out, wash, do this twist, everything, it's frustrating for me. It's very hard for me. A lot of my friends would agree who have hair like mine that they have a hard time taking care of it. What I think that the mistake may have been that I made was saying it on a social platform, saying it out in public, maybe being honest.
No. If you do not know Doja Cat, there is a booming natural hair community on YouTube. And a lot of them definitely do discuss the struggles of dealing with type 4 hair, and particularly 4C hair, complaining about in the clip that resurfaced. Now, the issue is not complaining about your 4C hair to an extent, because y'all know I already be coming at y'all for that shit. That whole, oh my God, I hate my fucking hair. Oh my God, like, I'd rather just relax it. Da, da, da. Weave is a lot easier to do it. I hate that, and it really annoys me because it pushes the rhetoric that we need to have straight hair or looser textured hair in order for it to be manageable or healthy. Just say that you yourself don't know how to take care of your hair. Say that you don't know what steps to take. You do not know the products that work in your hair. Say that you don't know the porosity level. But always, if you're gonna make comments about your hair, make sure you're saying it about your hair. Because when people look at you, especially these little black girls that look up to you and they have the same type of hair as you, or these little mixed girls that got the same type of hair as you, and you're sitting there degrading it like, oh my God, fuck 4C hair, this, that, and the third, that translates negatively to them. It's not the fact that you are honest. A lot of us are honest about our hair. But it's about the words you choose and the way you say it. Like, if you're sitting there like, oh, fuck 4C hair, this, that, and the third, that's not going to be a positive message for all the little girls out there that have that type of hair texture. It's just not. And if you don't know how to take care of your hair, you need to attribute it to, I don't know how to take care of my hair. It's not my 4C hair, it's me. Because I'm ignorant to the fact that I don't know how to take care of my hair. So that's the issue, but carry on.
About how I feel about taking care of my hair was a bad idea. To me, absolutely not. Mm-hmm. If I think that it's difficult, if I feel that it's difficult to take care of my hair, I'm gonna state it. If I don't know what it's like to, I'm sure I'm right now, my hairline is fine. I think I look great. I don't look like the most beautiful person on the planet, because that's just fact, but I'm fine with my hairline now. But wearing wigs, seeing how my hairline flattened and this tan that you get when you wear it, that shit threw me off. So I'm saying that, you know, I didn't understand the pain that it was to have a wig on all the time and taking it off and seeing the tan line and seeing all that. That bothered me. That pissed me off. I didn't like that. It doesn't, in no fucking way does it mean that I hate my hair. My hair is amazing.
She literally was sitting there talking about some fuck 4C. Like, are we really joking right now? Like, this is, you know what? I don't know if I'm gonna be able to watch the rest of this shit, because we have a lot more to go. She's not really redeeming herself whatsoever. And I haven't heard not one, I apologize, I'm sorry, in this entire fucking video. And I know there's gonna be people that are like, oh well, but she apologized in the Instagram post. That's not enough. As you can see, she clearly said that it was from her and it was heavily edited and all this extra shit. So I want to see it in your fucking face. Not that I'm gonna forgive her ass, because clearly at this point it's 7:30, like, come on, 7 minutes and 37 seconds, and you're not even getting to the point. Like,
Jesus. I have beautiful hair. I get lots of compliments on it. It's an outer thing and it's an inner thing. I know that I'm beautiful. I love myself. That's why I parade myself on fucking social media constantly. Why do you think I'm on here all the time?
Marketing, bitch.
All right. Maybe common that sense. Didn't sum it up for you. I love my skin color. I think I'm beautiful. The times that maybe there was a photo that was lightened to a certain point. That shit just happens. Mm-hmm. I'm not...
That I give her.
Editing my photos. This is a whole team of people who are behind editing. You can speak to them, not me. Now.
No, because at the end of the day, team or not, I would hope that your team shows you whatever it is that they want you to post, or whatever they post before they post it. I would hope. Because in this day and age, anything can be misconstrued. And even if that wasn't the case, this shit goes around so many people. Like, come on now. This is ridiculous. Like, these excuses, like, don't ask, go ask them, don't ask me. Like, excuse me? Of course we're gonna ask you, bitch. You're in the picture. You allowed this photo to be circulated. Let's be real here, but okay.
These are my bullet points. Didn't do nothing. This is in no way, shape, or form an order of what's most important to what, but it's there, so I'm gonna talk about it. So I made a song, I think it was 2015.
Oh, finally, what I care about.
and it has a very offensive term in it. Mm-hmm. And it shouldn't be used, period. I'm going to start with, I'm very sorry to anybody who's taken offense, to anybody who's, who I've hurt, using this term. When I used it, it was because I was in chat rooms all the time and I was kind of locked away and I was always on there just dealing with people coming at me left and right, talking about different slanderous terms after another.
Like I said in my other video, if people are slandering you somewhere, you can simply just delete your fucking account, or in this case, leave the damn chat room. I genuinely will never understand why people act like internet is like their end all be all. Like, social media is my job. YouTube is my full-time job. And I know how to turn my fucking phone off. I know how to block people. I know how to delete accounts. This is logic I don't fucking understand, and I don't think I will ever understand, because like, why would you continue to go somewhere or log into something where people are making fun of you? Just doesn't make sense to me.
The term that I used in the song is one that I learned that day. So people were calling me it left and right, and I used it in a song.
Isn't that crazy that I'm not hiding from the public?
Wait! We're not gonna do this! We're not! What are you talking about? When did this shit first resurface? Like, 2-3 days ago? What were you doing? We're in quarantine. We're in quarantine. So, kisa what the fet on that side.
Isn't it crazy that I'm not hiding?
Well, what were you doing for the past couple days? Sleeping? We not gonna do this. We're not! What are you talking about? When did this shit first resurface? Like, 2-3 days ago? What were you doing? We're in quarantine. We're in quarantine. So, kisa what the fet on that side.
Isn't it crazy that I'm not hiding?
Well, what were you doing for the past couple days? Sleep, bitch? God, I miss you.
And it was to kind of...
You wrote that song in a span of a couple hours to a day? Didn't she say she wrote notes? Whatever notes she wrote, they're fucking trash. Because these explanations don't make sense. They really don't. What? Okay, let's keep going.
Take back and... and fucking just say fuck you to those people. The song, however, I agree, the worst, maybe the worst song in the entire world. Not good. Lyrically, lost. The worst song. The lyrics in the song don't make sense. I see some of the interpretations of the lyrics. A lot of them are wrong. I can rewrite the lyrics for you guys. I don't know how important that is. But if you need me to, I can. But that song is in no way connected to police brutality or Sandra Bland. And
I beg to differ. Especially with the timing of the song, I beg to fucking differ. But if that's what she says, I guess we gotta accept it.
To see something like that, to see a song, my song that I made, connected to an innocent black woman's death, is one of the most awful rumors that I've ever encountered. I don't see in any way how that's okay to push and create a story like that around.
All right, comment down below if you are buying this explanation. I'm a little bit on the fence, but honestly, as much as her explanations are like really annoying me at this point and really genuinely don't make any sense, she sounds legitimately genuine. I'm gonna have to say that right now. Like, she sounds very genuine. And she sounds like all of this is coming from the heart. Like, I'm gonna have to say it. Like, as much as many of y'all may hate her right now, she does have a point. People do tend to spin shit and tend to like throw narratives until one sticks, which I do not think is okay whatsoever. In this case, she actually seems genuine. She really does, but let's keep watching because there's a lot more to go, okay? I hope y'all got y'all snacks. Hope y'all got y'all food, y'all water, because this is like a lot, okay? A lot.
Next bullet is stripping for white supremacists.
Yup, that's what you were doing.
I am gonna start with the chat room that I go to is a public chat room. Mm-hmm. It's me, my friends, you go in there. Now you have to pay $30 to get into the chat room, mm-hmm. which is a new thing. But I used to go in there for free. And I learned, you know, that there are racist people who come in and out of the chat. Mm-hmm. They're there. They happen and then they're banned. The idea that this chat room is a white supremacist chat room is, I don't understand it in any way. And it not even full, I just don't understand how, you know what I do understand? Is that there is racism that happens across Tiny Chat. And there is racism that happens across Instagram. There's racism that happens across Twitter. This shit happens everywhere.
It does.
It just happens more on Tiny Chat because it's not as monitored.
Okay.
So when you see racist shit on Tiny Chat, it's because people aren't paying attention. There are mods that are idle. This happens. And there was a time where I was a mod and I was able to ban people mm-hmm. for actions like that or being harassing women. This happens a lot on Tiny Chat. But Tiny Chat is a place for everybody.
You know what? I'm tired of people like excusing this type of behavior by like, yeah, it happens everywhere. Just like how I deleted TikTok and the people that love TikTok so damn much and can't live without it was sitting there like, oh, but this happens everywhere. That's not the fucking point. Any platform that allows that type of caca to happen is trash. Whether there's mods or not, like I wouldn't sit there on a chat room that I know is prone to have lots of racist and disrespectful people on it and stay on there. Like, it just doesn't make sense. If I know there's racist people who don't like black people and misogynistic men who like to say disrespectful shit to a woman on there, why would I continue to go on there? Like, the lack of common sense is ridiculous these days. Like, it just doesn't make sense, but all right.
It's a place for all walks of life. And sometimes it's hurtful to people. It's hurtful to my fans because of me. Because I spent time maybe not banning at the right... I've seen it, and I know that I've been targeted by it, mm-hmm. and I know that it's controllable. But the narrative that it's a white supremacist chat is completely incorrect. It's absolutely 100% fucking incorrect. The next thing is race play. So I watched a YouTube video by ABBA and Preach.
Oh shit.
Interesting people. They can be very smart in a lot of subjects. Ooh. And I enjoyed a few videos by them. But there was a video about me that came out a few hours ago. I don't think it's been a day.
Yeah, I haven't seen this one yet.
The video that came out was about me, and they misinterpreted what I said in a clip on Tiny Chat. So the clip that you see me, where I was, and yes, this is me 100% fucking excusing my dumbass behavior. I'm dumb, but I'm also drunk. But on the other side of things, I can be concise, I can be clear, I can speak, I know how to speak. I am smart, but I'm also kind of a dumbass. In this video, I'm being completely fucking blackout drunk and completely fucking dumb. I have turned off the smart switch in my brain.
I need to see this clip.
This is where I'm saying, shut the fuck up, you, and then I say hard R, the N-word. Now, they thought that I was saying, and maybe some of you thought that I was saying, call me the hard R N-word. I'm in no way into race play. It's not something that, I don't know anybody who does it. These people who made this video about me are Abbott and Preach, who made this video. I think it was Preach that knows people who are into race play. I am in no way. I am completely not into it. I'm kinky as fuck. Very kinky. but to that extent, no. So I think that that's where they tied it in. Maybe Preach thought that I was talking about race play, or I was trying to perform that in public, in some way in the chat, but that's completely fucking false. I think they just misheard me, but that's the truth. Tiny chat being white supremacist, that was one bullet. I debunk that. Arabic tweet. Now,
the okay, Arabic... 2 seconds. 2 seconds. Okay, so I didn't watch Abelman Preach's video yet. I'm gonna have to go watch it now after this. But if what she's explaining is true, whether it's Abelman Preach's version or her version, that shit is fucking wild. Like, why are you even saying why are you even saying the N-word in a derogatory way in the first place? As a mixed person, we all know mixed people are now being like castigated in the black community. Okay, a lot of people like to say that mixed people are not black, mixed people ain't our allies, mixed people this, that, and the third. So for you as a mixed person who's been allowed to say nigga this, nigga that in every fucking song, for you to turn around and call someone a nigga with an E-R, that don't look good for you. Whether you said, you know, whether they're trying to make it seem like you were race playing or not, either story is equally trash. So I don't even know, she should just let that one alone. Because first of all, like, neither one makes you look any better, bitch. Like, oh my God. Doja Cat. I want to know how she recovers from this. Yeah, I think, do y'all think this is going to destroy her, or you think nothing going to happen to her? Because now I'm on the fence, because this explanation, honestly, as much as I hate, like, trash, ash, cookie cutter type of motherfucking apologies, this right here probably fucked her up even more, but let's keep on watching.
A lot of my fans went and pretty much slammed that. I haven't addressed it, but I feel like this is the perfect time to, I have never made a tweet about Arabic people, Arabic culture. I don't even see why someone would do, it's a shitty rumor. It's an awful, horrible rumor.
So where's the tweet at? Was it a fake tweet?
So there's nothing much else to say about that.
I ain't see the Arabic tweet. That's wild.
That's bullshit.
Y'all was digging up shit for real.
Sandra Bland. I clocked that. Not showing my boobs. We're getting down to the real, to the unimportant bullshit now. So I have three more left. Maybe one of them is kind of important. Maybe two. Two out of three, I guess. Not showing my boobs. I should have left that for the last. Let's move on to the next one. Dating white men.
I don't think that's a problem.
It's so interesting to me how in these times, me dating white men is in any way. I've seen comments about it, and it has, I'm completely empty in thought as far as this goes. When I love someone, when I am attracted to someone, when I want to fuck someone, I'm gonna either see how that fucking pans out, I'm going to talk to them, and that's all that fucking matters, is what I fucking want. Who I love is zero. Whether you like me or not, it's zero of your business.
This is actually the most sensible thing she said this entire fucking video. the people that are against interracial dating need to take several seats. I think that's seriously an issue. I feel like the reason people are legit dragging her is because they drag everyone who dates outside of their race, okay? Whether it's an Asian married to a Hispanic person or a black person married to a white person, whatever the case may be, people will always have something to say about it, and that's sad because we're in 2020 and we still live in a time where no one can marry, date, associate with anyone romantically who is not of their race. And that's really fucked up. But I feel like people are really, really came hard body for her is because all of this, you know, shit that came up, and then you dating white men, and then you got a song talking about some niggas ain't shit. Ah, that don't make you look good, sis. Niggas ain't shit, niggas ain't shit, niggas ain't shit. But hey, here's my white nigga. Like, what? Because, you know, like, but then again, a lot of people use the word nigga to define men in general. Like, it doesn't matter if you're black, white, whatever. People just say niggas ain't shit. So it all depends on how you're reading into it. I feel like a lot of people were reaching with that. That's why I didn't mention that in my other video. I feel like anyone should be able to date whoever they want. But if you couple that with the self-hatred, when you couple that with the self-hatred ideology, when you couple that with the whole, you know, being on live with white supremacists, when you couple that with hating your hair, when you couple that with the fact that you never met your dad and you spoke about that in not such a, you know, positive way, like, it just all rounds up to looking like, okay, like, she hate black people, she's only capitalizing off the black dollar, you know, that's really what it looks like. So let me know what y'all think about that down in the comment section below. I personally don't give a shit. I never have cared about who anyone dates because, like she said, that's none of my damn business. And I believe that it's beautiful that people can love one another when they're not from the same place, but that's just my personal opinion.
If I like someone, if I'm attracted to a person, no matter what their skin color is, no matter where the fuck they come from, no matter what their religion, doesn't matter, I don't give a fuck, I'm gonna fucking love them because I love them. This isn't about fucking, I don't date people based on, I don't even know how to articulate that concept because it's so out of my world. If I love someone, I'm not looking at their fucking skin color. I find people attractive just because I find them fucking attractive.
That's how it should be.
If I find a black man attractive, it's because he's fucking attractive. If I find an Asian man attractive, it's because he's fucking attractive. If I find a white man attractive, it's because he's fucking attractive. And that's it. But you can create it, you can spin it, and you can do whatever you want. We have a lot of time. We're on quarantine. We have so much time to sit in bed. If you're not an essential worker, if you're an essential worker, thank you. Thank you so much. If you're not an essential worker, good luck, motherfucker. And you're trying to make me look like shit on the internet? Good luck, motherfucker. You have nothing else to do. I understand. You have fun. You do that shit.
That escalated not so quickly, but this is not helping your case.
Now, Beyonce TikTok. I saw something about.
I haven't seen that one yet.
That I was coming for Beyonce. Beyonce is the cream of the fucking crop. Beyonce is the reason why I believe that I can be who I am. Beyonce is one of the driving forces of who I am in my career. Beyonce is undeniably talented.
Yeah, I've heard about this, but I haven't seen it.
Every time anyone has ever came for Beyonce, I was there. And that's all I have to say. That's it. Next fucking bullet. Not showing my boobs.
Now, what is this boob thing? I'm lost.
So,
I don't think I remember this one.
Told people on Twitter that I was gonna show my boobs to them real hard.
I remember that.
Quote unquote. And some people think that I was serious. They realized that I wasn't serious very recently. That's my sense of humor.
I would hope that you're not.
My mistake was thinking that everyone was going to understand my joke. And by the way, I don't give a shit about being fucking famous. I don't give a fuck about a number one, okay? I don't even know what that means at this point. Having a number one is you have a number one. And that's it. Maybe people buy you fucking, I don't know, they give you sneakers. I don't know what, having a number one is so fucking irrelevant to me.
I don't know why she's playing stupid. We all know that having a number one in the music industry is very, very, like, big. It's a big thing. It's a career milestone. Like, Nicki Minaj don't even got another one. Oh, wait. I think she does now, right? With Doja? Oh, shit. I think she does now. But any type of number ones that Nicki Minaj has ever had, from what I remember, has been featured. She hasn't had, like, a solo be number one. Correct me if I'm wrong down in the comments. So it's like, not every successful singer or rapper gets a number one. So if you have a number one, it's a pretty big deal. So for her to sit there and talk about, well, I don't know, like, what's number one? Is that important to me? Bitch, having a number one is important to every fucking artist, okay? That's like me saying my plaque. Can y'all see that? My plaque's right here. Oh, it's cut off. That's like saying my 100,000 subscriber plaque is not important. It is important. It's a motherfucking milestone. Is this something that, oh, okay, I want a $1 million plaque now. I'm going to post every single day. I want that shit. No, but it's an important milestone. So don't act like you don't fucking know, bro. Like, come on. Like, this is ridiculous at this point.
I just like to make music. That's why I'm here. And that's why you know who I am. Okay. Because I make music.
That makes sense.
The not showing my boobs shit, I don't even want to address it. It's a lot of Fortnite kids and gamer kids who just wish they could have seen my boobers. But that's not a fucking... You know what? Something that I realized is when I post after getting a number one, I said, you know, of course, thank you to my teams. Thank you to everybody for working for me, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. Things like that that are important to thank people for that I understand. But saying, oh my God, I can't believe this moment. I really made it to this point. Your favorite artists, and there is no judgment. If they care about that, wonderful. That's fine. There's nothing wrong about wanting a number one and working hard to get to that number one. For me, I don't give a shit. I just want to fucking make music. I don't care about a fucking... I still don't get it. I don't understand fully what a number one means.
Why are we even talking about that?
It means you made it number one.
People were saying... I even said that.
And then you fucking plummet, like me. My shit's gonna keep going down. There's gonna be times where I start here, and I go here, then I go here, then I go here.
With everyone.
It's gonna happen all the time. So, you know, me trying to sell my titties for a number one, that was just even more the point that I'm doing it because I love the people around me. If I want a number one, I'm doing it because I fucking want my fans to be proud of me. I want my team to be proud of me. It's not because, God damn, I need a fucking number one. It's not about that. It's about me just wanting the people around me to be fucking happy. So I just... It's crazy when you know... I get the joke. I get the... You lied. My homies hate Doja Cat. I understand.
I don't even know why people thought that was serious.
To you, doxing me is psychotic.
That is weird. That I agree with.
You probably know that. But I understand, you know, I know you guys know the joke around it all. I know the joke. You know?
Honestly, Again, with the number one shit, it's pretty difficult, and it is a very, very significant milestone. I don't think it makes sense to work that hard to please everyone around you. I think that's complete bullshit. As far as talking about some, oh, I'ma show y'all my booze, knowing damn well you have kids on your fucking platform, it's bad enough that all female rappers rap about this fucking sex and getting banged and drugging niggas and shit. So when you sit there and like you say something like that on a platform where you know there's like genuine Fortnite kids on there, like what do you think, what kind of response you think is gonna get? Like, I don't know, I feel like we just need more female rappers that actually rap about genuine shit. Like, we need more fucking Lauryn Hill, Jill Scott, Missy Elliott, fucking The Brat. Like, we need people that actually rap about something of substance. Because at this point, like, these people are just utter trash. Like, why do you even think it's okay to post something like that on Twitter, like, joke or not? But
so I just wanted to say, you know, that's how I feel. The last point that I want to make is that I love you guys so fucking much.
Here we go with that bullshit.
I love my fans.
On that note, I'm checking my phone.
And fucking give you, oh, I'm deep.
Okay, I'm sorry. I don't care. I don't care. Okay, anyways, y'all get the gist of the fucking video. I'm going to link this down below so you guys can watch it for yourself and tell me what y'all think about it, because I'm done. So, in conclusion, all right, I don't think the video was that bad. I feel like she explained herself thoroughly well. I feel like she has made some really poor decisions, and she definitely needs to get it together. I don't buy the self-hatred explanation. I don't buy the number one hit explanation. I don't buy a lot of it. I'm gonna tell you this right now. I don't buy it, but I feel like she articulated herself pretty damn well for who she is. Let me know what you think about it down in the comment section below. Do you think that this was a genuine explanation? And I feel like she only apologized once. Yeah, she only apologized once, and that's like a 30-minute video. So, I mean, what do you think about that? Do you think she should apologize for every single thing? But realistically, if you don't feel like you did anything wrong, or you feel like you don't have to say you didn't do it, like if you feel like you didn't do anything wrong, or you feel like you apologized before, or if you feel like you didn't like have to apologize for something, you won't. So, I mean, I'm just gonna get at to her. Like, she clearly just doesn't feel like she's done anything. She doesn't feel like she has to apologize for any of this in a genuine sense. Which, to be quite honest, depending on who you are, you may feel different. I'm sure a lot of people are still thoroughly upset, because I was reading comments under some people's posts that reposted snippets of this, and people were just like, no, the cancel still stands. So let me know down in the comment section below. Does the cancel still stand? Do you think that any of this was sincere? Do you believe that Doja Cat's career will survive this? Because I am very, very 50-50. I'm really, really on the fence. I don't know how this is gonna affect her, but at the same time, her fan base is mostly white people for the most part. So honestly, I think she's still going to be just fucking fine, and she's just going to go through the normal motions of sometimes being really, really popular and sometimes not. But I'm sure this is gonna follow her for the rest of her life, and she's probably gonna have to apologize again. That's why I'm sure she told people to film it, I mean, to record it, because it's just definitely gonna resurrect itself over and over again, because that's what happens with these types of situations. Honestly, I'm still not gonna support her, but I guess I appreciate the explanation. I'm just not buying 90% of it. I'm just not, that's just me. I'm over it. Like I said, let me know down in the comment section below, what do you think about all of this? Also, make sure you get your merchandise. This is my Pro Common Sense sweatshirt. And make sure you follow me on Instagram. Make sure to like, share, subscribe, do all of that. And I'ma see y'all next time.